Hi, I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip. This is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. Today I'm going to be talking to you about how to choose different loops and go through a couple of examples. So we have for loops, while loops, and do while loops. And you may be wondering, how do I know which loop is the most appropriate for a given problem? So this is our computer science if-else statement that will help us think through this. So if by the time a loop starts, you already know exactly how many times the loop will be run, so this is a counting loop, then we want to use a for loop. It's good style, it's compact, and you don't have update code that's mixed in with your body of your loop. If that's not true, then we have to look at other options. So if we don't know how many times we need to iterate, then we're going to either use a while loop or a do while. If the loop has to be done at least once, if the body of the code in the loop has to be done at least once, then we're going to use a do while loop. And if that's not true, then we're just going to use a regular while loop. And this allows us to have the option that the code inside the while loop actually never executes if the condition associated with the while loop never becomes true. Okay, so let's think a little bit more about just what the different aspects of these different types of loops are. So for loops, we want to use when we need to repeat something a specific certain number of times. So we want to go through every student's grades and calculate a letter grade. Well, we know how many students we have, so that's a for loop. Or if we want to go through a range of numbers and perform a calculation on each number, that's a good use of a for loop because we know how many numbers we have in our range. While loops are something we want to use when we're unsure of the number of iterations and we need to keep going until some condition is met. This is often the case if we're dealing with user input because we don't know what the user is going to do, or if we're dealing with random elements in our code. So if we're moving a ball randomly until it moves off the canvas, that's a really good example of a while loop because we don't know how many random moves it's going to take until the ball is off the canvas. Or if we're asking a user to input a number between 1 and 10, we have to keep asking them until they actually enter a valid number, just to take care of the case that they start entering letters or negative numbers or bigger numbers or what have you. And we don't know how many times it's going to take to get a valid number from the user. So let's go through an example. So our first example is this idea of we're going to write a static program that will sum the odd numbers up to 50. So we want to calculate 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, etc., all the way up to and including summing in 49. So the questions we want to ask are, what type of loop should we use? How do we initialize it? What's the condition? And how do we update things? So in this case, we know how many iterations are needed because it's the odd numbers up to 50. So we're going to use a for loop. And our initializer is we're going to set a variable to 1, which is the very first odd number. And the condition is we're going to run the loop while the variable is less than or equal to 50. And then our update is we're going to increment by 2, and that's how we get the next odd number. So this code ends up looking like this. Int sum equals 0 because we need a variable to store the sum in. And then we're going to iterate across I from 1 to 50 and incrementing by 2 each time. And each time we're going to take whatever I is and add it into sum. So the first time we're going to come in here, we're going to add 1 to sum. Sum will be 1. And then we're going to add 2 to I. I will be 3. So now we're going to add 3 to sum. So now we've added 1 and 3, etc. We're going to do this all the way up until I is less than or equal to 50. So we'll do it for 49. I will become 51, and we won't add 51 into our sum. All right, so here's another example. What if we want to write a static program that draws a series of balls? Actually, this shouldn't be a static program. If we want to draw a program that draws a series of balls until a ball is off the canvas. Begin with the first ball at the center of the canvas, and for each ball, we want to add random X and Y components to the coordinates of the previous ball. So we're going to have a ball at the center of canvas. Its position is going to be width over 2, height over 2. And then we're going to add a little bit to the ball X and add a little bit to the ball Y. And we're going to have a new ball that's going to be somewhere down to the left, right of it. And then we're going to keep on doing that. And at some point, the ball is going to be beyond the bottom of the canvas or beyond the right side of the canvas, and we want to stop. So what type of loop should we use? Well, we don't know how many times we're going to have to add to the ball position. So we're going to use a while loop. And our initializers, we're going to set the position of the first ball to width over height, or width over 2 and height over 2. So we've got ball x is width over 2 and ball y is height over 2. Our condition is actually going to be if ball x is greater than or equal to width, or if ball y is greater than or equal to height. If either of those two things are true, we want to actually stop adding random stuff to our ball. And then our update is to calculate the next ball position. So this is where we're going to get random bits to add to ball x and ball y. So here's what the code looks like. We have to initialize ball x to width over 2 and ball y to height over 2. We have a while loop, and our condition is a compound condition. So while ball x is less than width or ball y is less than height, that's our continuation condition. So while either of those is true, then we're going to draw an ellipse, and we're using ball x and ball y as a position. The ball is going to be have a diameter of 10. And then ball x plus equals random of 10. So we're going to add a little bit to the x position, add a little bit to the y position each time through. And at some point, one of these things is not going to be true. And when both of them are not true, then we are going to stop the loop. All right. So one last thing to talk about here is to just be careful about overusing the for loop or the counting loop. So sometimes it's really complicated to figure out how many times you'd need to iterate. It's possible, but complicated. And really, there's an easier way to do this using a while loop. So for example, if we want to draw a bunch of lines that are size pixels long, with a gap between each line. So basically we're drawing like a big dashed line. We want to draw as many as possible, but we only want to draw whole lines, and we want to stop before we draw a partial line that extends past the right side of the canvas. We're going to start at x equals 0. So the bad idea would be to calculate how many lines there needs to be, because we've got to calculate the lines and the gaps and divide that by the width and make sure that we have enough space and don't go over the edge. So it's possible, but it's just a little tricky. And so you could calculate this and write a for loop that looks like this. For int I equals 0, I is less than num lines, I plus plus, and then you draw the line like this. What's a better idea is to just keep on drawing lines as long as they fit. So in this case, we're going to say left end equals 0. And while left end plus the size is less than the width. So this means we're taking where we currently are, adding the size of the line. And as long as we can do that and we're not going over the width of the canvas, then let's do it. So in that case, we draw a line from left end, and our height is going to be the same each time, to left end plus size. So that draws a little dashed line, and then we add the line size plus the gap to get to the next starting point. And then again, we're going to check and make sure that we're still not beyond the right side of the canvas. And so this is just a simpler way to achieve this without having to do complex calculations, which are prone to errors. All right, so that's it for choosing loops and thinking through the right way to use the right kind of loop for a problem. Thanks for watching.